The police are not going to keep you safe. The police do not prevent crime. They show up after the bad thing is happening. If you're black and you call 911, you automatically become a suspect. Or if you're poor, or if you're a person of color.
I want the vice president to acknowledge it too as well. If we don't hold them responsible, how in the hell can we look at people and say, just vote? Yet at the end of the day, Kamala Harris, when she was the state attorney general, was fighting the damn Supreme Court that was telling her to release people. And yet, oh, we're supposed to go vote, let's go. Those destroy black men in America.
Yeah.
It destroyed my race. In the state of Texas, the number one lowest statistics in state schools is what? What race? What gender? The black man. And you tell me, hey, oh, let's go vote for Joe Biden. Let's go. No, damn it. No, because we remember those words called super predator. Right? I do believe that Donald Trump is the greatest threat to American democracy right now. And yet I believe that every time black people have fought in this country, they have opened the doors for everybody. Why we are here today with Breonna Taylor. Today, while we fought for those liberties, we are still fighting like hell to make sure that black women are protected in this country. And yet at the end of the day, everybody's gotten justice and different things of that nature. And yet Breonna Taylor's killers are still walking the street. They're still doing whatever they want to do. And they killed this girl. They murdered her. Justice, I'm getting tired of putting justice for in front of somebody's baby's name. It's almost like we got PTSD because it's countless names. I can't even remember them. And yet after we sit so comfortable. So I'm so grateful for this rainbow coalition that I see out here. And when you say Black Lives Matter, I want you to tell those oppressive systems to get their thumb and get their foot off the social economic element of our communities. Black Lives Matter is just not about these oppressive policies. We're trying to make sure that we can live in our community and that the tax base of our community is invested back in our community. And guess what? You can save your damn officers and we can protect our community. Stand up. Stand up.
We need all black lives. I mean, black queer folks, black trans folks. If you black, we love you, we see you, we appreciate you. And with that, I'm gonna pass the mic to Miss Amazing.
Thank you. How are you guys doing? Thank you guys for staying. My name is Miss Amazing Head, Head Bitch and Man. I am the self-proclaimed queen of ATX. I am born and raised here in Austin, Texas. Get some noise. Feel that drunk off in Texas.
I'm here as a representation of black, queer, trans, live, the LGBTQIA, all that. I'm all that. So I'm just going to fill you in a little bit about me. I'm a pioneer in the LGBT community here in Austin, Texas, especially in the black community. As you all know, Austin culture, black culture has been pushed out. I moved away from Austin back in 2012. I went around the whole world trying to find home. And I ended up coming back home about 2 years ago, and I was homeless.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, homeless. I am the founder of Austin Queer Cultural Center. I am designing shelter, school, and jobs for my community. But if we're all gonna say Black Lives Matter, all Black Lives Matter, I matter. I'm gonna fill you in for a little bit of my world. I think last year 33 black trans women were murdered. 33. Not one police officer killed them, those women. The black community did. So starting in June, we came out here and we marched for, you know, the police brutality is to stop killing black people, black men. But who's gonna march for us? Hello? I don't matter. Well, I do. So I will be the one that's always out there on the front line. If I gotta wait all day to get my voice heard, if Devin has to wait all day to get her voice heard, that's what we will do, because there's other children just like us growing up need someone to look up to. I didn't have that, so I created and pioneered my ass to the top.
Community programs, community outreach, and job readiness.
And if you guys don't think that black queer people, hire black people, right? Hire a queer person. You know, I'm proud to say, you know, my job I have had for 10 years, I was a sex worker. Talk about me all you want. That's the hand that was played for me. So now I took it upon myself to create my own job, create in my own community, for my own. And if you guys don't understand that, try doing what I do, walk in my shoes. I'm out here talking about Black Lives Matter, but Black Lives don't acknowledge all Black lives. Be on that drum, baby. I was watching this football player. He had a suit on. And the whole suit was head to toe with names of all the black people that died at the care of police. That was fucking crazy. A whole suit, names, head to toe. And I thought to myself, oh God, what can I do to stop that from happening in the black, trans, queer LGBT community? Because cops are not killing us. If you guys want to support Austin Queer Cultural Center, look it up on Instagram, on Facebook. I'm starting a GoFundMe because I will create a space here. And I'm going to give this mic to Devin. Beautiful one. You love that.
Hello, beautiful people. Thank you for being here. I am part of the Black Trans Leadership Boston. I am a black queer cis woman. Quick show of hands. How many people have read the Black Lives Matter statement? People, for some reason, don't understand, and it's because they haven't actually done their research. They're all about, let's chant Black Lives Matter, let's hashtag Black Lives Matter. Do your research about what you are supporting. The Black Lives Matter movement centers trans and non-binary people, period. Doing that every single day, because we are not fighting for black lives. Sustained by black queer women. Thank you for showing up. You're doing all of this for us. A few weeks ago, I was at an event and I heard about the Hayo guys, Lakota Sacred Time. And I was inspired. So I want to lead y'all through something. Black people, I would like you to stand tall. Find your base and stand in your power. Everyone else, I need you to step up. This is gonna be hard. Do it anyway. I need everyone to take a deep breath for me. Now repeat after me. Kill black people. Say it. Throw them in cages and make them our slaves. Make them sick. Take their resources, their culture, their life, and give them no bread. Then demand more. How did that feel in your body?